I'm back.
What's going on, guys? David Lillian back again with yet another tutorial. And I hope you guys did enjoy that intro. It was kind of fun to make. I just thought I had done this video or done this about half this tutorial, and then I realized I was only recording myself and not the screen also. So right now I'm going to try to get through this one a little bit quick. I may have to cut some parts out just because I just don't want to do that all again. But anyways, a lot of you requested to see the transfer tracker PSD, you know, how I do it. So I'm going to show you guys that today, and we're actually going to do one for Leonardo Bonucci as he's just made a shock move to AC Milan yesterday. So I'm going to get back on track with this stuff. So anyways, I just want to show you guys the base layers here. Basically, you start off just a black base. I just want to get rid of the text here. Just a black base. Then I got this kind of dramatic photo of fans in a stadium. I think that's Chile. It says Santiago there, and I see some Chilean flags. And I just want to make that black and white. You can throw a filter on it, like a black and white filter, maximum black, maximum white. It didn't really matter to me. Just made it black and white. Then next, I just have this square. So basically, the way to do that is you just want to go to the rectangle tool down here. You hold down shift, and you just make your square here. I'll show you here. So just I'm holding down shift, and then boom, keeps it all in proportion. And then you make a rectangle. You can make that any color you want. So what I did is I kind of made it like a dark gray, put it on soft light, and then put an effect on it, an outer glow. Now the way to do that is just you can like click on it like this, or click double click it, and then it brings you, that's for any layer, you can just double click it and it brings you to that menu there. Or you can go down here, sorry, down here to the FX and do any of these. So I do outer glow, and if you want to see the exact specifications for that outer glow, sorry, that is for the next one. If you want to see the exact specifications for the outer glow, right there it is. So you can see it's white, blend mode screen, opacity 64, spread 8, and size 73 pixels. That's pretty much all I needed. The size of this image is 1764 pixels by 1764 pixels. So just in case you wanted to know. Then I put a lighter gray, same rectangle, so I just duplicated the image. Same rectangle, just made it lighter and set it on hard light. It's really zero difference, but hey, you know, it's there. Next layer is my watermark. So I just kind of fade that in at the top just so nobody really sees it. And then next I have the photo filter. So luckily I won't have to change it. It's just red for AC Milan. Yeah. So basically I'll get into the rest of the stuff next. But the only thing you really need to know, the text is in the font Courier. And this is size 40. And the one that I do for the rest of the text, like for example, is nationality of Egypt. That is size 80, so it's a double size. Basically, what I had done was I put the players' heads on jerseys of other players or bodies of other players. So basically here I have Manuel Locatelli from AC Milan, and we're just going to be putting Bonucci's head on him. So what I've already done is I've already cut out Bonucci's head and kind of faded it in. This is where I was when I realized that the was not recording me, or it was not recording the screen, it was just recording me. So this is at the point where I was. So it's a kind of a good point. I think most of you can figure out how to get here. If you need help, definitely refer to my older videos. I know I have some simpler tutorials. But like I said, I am trying to go quick, and I do apologize. But I am back doing these tutorials. That is the important thing. I promised a summer return, and here we are. Just did a big rebrand. I'm getting a shirt in with my logo on it, so I'm really excited. Anyways, a few things I noticed here. I have some hairs sticking out from behind Bonucci's head from the original picture. So the way to take care of that, pretty simply, I'm just going to rasterize this by hitting the eraser and then hitting the image and hitting OK. So I'm just going to use the clone stamp tool. So I've used this a lot in the past, especially my last video of Bryce Harper. And we're just going to want to go and hit Alt or Option, whatever it says on your computer. For me, it says both. Hit Alt. And we're just going to want to click. That picks up the pixels from the area that you click. So if I clicked right on the badge, held down the button, and clicked, it would pick up the badge. So we're on a nice soft brush up here, as you can see. So I'm just going to want to pick up the areas behind him and just kind of cross out those unneeded hairs there and unneeded things in the background. Just anything around his head that we don't really want. So I think that's good. The rest is just cutting errors for me. And you can always go in and refine. So let's say I really didn't want this white bit here. You can always go in with the eraser. And now I'm on, obviously, Bonucci's head. You can just cut around that. And maybe, whoops, there's another hair there, so we can go back in. I know this is like the smallest detail, but you know what? If you really want to take your time, then do it because it's more than recommend. Anyways, though, we can see that the skin tones don't really match. It seems like Benucci's skin is a lot, it seems darker and more saturated. So a simple solution to that, this kind of makes anything work, is always go to Command U and just take down the saturation a bit. And there you go, you have it. What I also like to do is maybe if I'm trying to match really different skin tones, I can take the levels of one and bring them down or up depending on the direction that I needed to go. So I can actually bring the levels up on this as it does look, matches the hands a little bit. You can always obviously take the hands and match them to the face. Doesn't really matter either way. That's probably actually easier because you don't have to worry about beard or hair or eyes or anything like that. I remember I once matched like Nathan Ake's skin tone with like a white Bournemouth player. So never forget. Anyways, I was photoshopping him to Bournemouth. You get the idea. Anyway, so now we have our picture. This looks like Leonardo Bonucci in an AC Milan shirt. So what we can just do is combine all these into one by pressing Shift and selecting all them and then Command E. Now we're going to go up and just give it a quick topaz readjust here. So just going to come on into denoise here. And I'm not sure why detail isn't here. I know you guys have all seen this before. You guys pretty much know what the deal is. You can watch me do this, but I'm just going to talk a little bit about my new Photoshop's Photoshop 2017, because 2014 wasn't working for me anymore. It didn't work physically. There was a problem with, I don't know if any of you have the solution, but basically it required an update. So I updated to 2017. Now I'm on 2017. So really no difference other than for some reason detail didn't transfer. So maybe I can figure out a way to get it on here. Oh, I'm tired. As it is a really helpful topaz. But anyways, I'll just do the basic denoise adjust clean. That's pretty simple. That's pretty much standard for all my edits here. Bring the radius down, bring the sharpness down, or bring the accent down. That's really the big one. And this is the point where I really wish I would use detail, but I can't, unfortunately. Maybe I'll just give it another adjust. When in doubt, when you don't have that extra detailing, I just like to give it another dynamic pop. You know, when in doubt, dynamic pop it out. That's what I say. Not really. Just give it a little transparency, and there we go. So now we have a picture of Bonucci on AC Milan. So we're just going to drag that over into the transfer tracker right here. And we're going to want to bring it up where the other picture was that we had of Mo Salah, as you can see right there. And I'll show you guys how to get that effect in just a second. So we're going to want to size it up a decent amount. And it's great to have these templates. Just remember to save them as a PSD. Actually, what I am going to want to do is I'm going to want to bring in the title here. So let's see, where is the title that says transfer tracker? There we go. I don't think that's the right one. Hold on a second. There we go. All right. That's the right one. Transfer tracker. So the other one, I made an old one. The first like couple in the series were of a weird font and different background, but either way, we have it the right one now. And we can bring in the arrow, why not? So the arrow is just from club one to club two. And as you can see, I had Liverpool and Roma for Salah. But now it's going to be Juventus and AC Milan. So basically here we go. I have, Bonucci, and to get that effect that I got with, Salah, we can just see, yep, it's at a pretty good height. What we're going to want to do is we're going to want to do a layer mask. So bring over your layer mask here. You're going to use the paint bucket tool. So go over to the gradient tool. Tap two fingers and get it to the paint bucket tool and just click. So now we have our images there, but we're just covering it with black paint. So we're going to want to go into the paintbrush tool and we are going to want to get a brush out that I actually don't have. So I gotta find it. Let's see, what is it called? I'll find it. All the brushes for Photoshop are under .abr. That's how I very easily find them in my computer when I forget the names. So I happen to know it is this recent one, Spoon Graphics dry brush set. I can link that. I'll make a file of all the pictures I used in this edit. So click down in the description. So I have that loaded in clearly, as you can see. And I just like these because they're really simple to use and they create really nice effects. So we're just going to want to go and just try to match it up as best as we can. Make sure we're on white and make sure we're clicking on the layer mask. If you click on the picture, it ends up looking like that. So we're going to want to click on the layer mask and just go around it. I like to orient the brushes so that they are vertical and not horizontal, so I'm not clicking around a ton. And when you get to the edge, you don't really want it to be like that. You want it a nice rigid edges. So I'm actually thinking that's pretty good. I'm liking the way that looks. So now as we go up the layers, we can see we have the Twitter announcement, which is usually now how clubs make things official. They announce them on Twitter, Instagram, all their social medias. So what I'll actually do is I'll actually bring in the all the text boxes that I have. And let's see, get the pound symbol there. That one, it didn't come with like a keyboard or whatever, so I had to find it. The flag and the logos. So, and the Twitter screenshot. So I think that's it. Basically, what makes this template so nice is that you can just change it really quickly. So watch, boom, right here. I always check on Google just to see, because a lot of guys, they have accents or weird things in their name, but I'll just to be sure, because I'm not the best speller, I will copy it straight from Wikipedia and put it straight into the picture. So that's pretty much what I usually do. Just select the text, go up here, copy, paste, boom, name Leonardo Bonucci. Age, he's 30. So we'll go down to the next one, which is 25, and hit 30. I always should really organize these into folders on the side, but you know, it's whatever. Position, I happen to know he's a center back. Center back, two words. And then, let's see, transfer fee. So they give it in euros. I calculated it to about 37 million pounds. For the most part, though, a lot of transfers are undisclosed. Some of them are not, like as we all know. Lukaku was 75 million. Yesterday, Kyle Walker was 50 million. But a lot of the international ones get a bit hazy, but we'll just call it 37 million. When in doubt, I just put undisclosed because it's really nice and easy. Then for nationality, we are going to put Italy, and we got to get a picture of the Italian flag. So we'll go again on Google. Italian flag. This again, you know, showing you the full process of how I do this here. Just gonna want to take this one. And we can, not that one, let's just do this one. Save it into the downloads. And there we go. So I like to keep the old ones up just so I can match up the sizes. Oh, somebody's calling, but I'm not gonna answer. And keep in mind, not all flags are the same dimensions. So, you know, if you're seeing, hold on. Okay. Anyways, we have the Italian flag in there. And the only thing left is the icons, the crest, and the Twitter announcement. So let's do the crest first. I happen to know that I'll leave them in here just so I can again match up the sizes and the locations. AC Milan have obviously been very active, so I do have their crest in here, and I'm pretty sure I have Juventus as well. There's AC Milan. So basically the way I get them like that, inverted, and then, inverted coloring, and also on that blend mode, basically what I do is I can bring them into a different window here. And I go to Image, Adjustments, Black and White. And then Infrared usually works, but in this case, it kind of blacks out a little bit too much, so I can just do Default. Then I go to Image, Adjustments, Contrast, and I always try to bring up the contrast, and we'll see which direction. The brightness changes it. Initially, the gray was going to turn to black. It's really all about how the grays and those mid-range colors turn. If they turn the color you want, great. If they turn the color you don't want, you got to figure out a way to reverse. So a great way to do that is the brightness. If you just bring up the brightness, that'll take the grays to the white. And if you brought the brightness down, it would take the grays to the black. But I really like that. So all I got to do now is click Command I, which inverts it, and then we can bring it back over to our transfer tracker. Has this lovely looking new logo. And we're just going to want to set that down right over where we have this. Doesn't really matter the exact size. And what we're going to want to do is we're just going to want to put the blend mode on screen. And there you have it. Where was it? I don't know. Am I on it? No. There it is. Settled right there, and now we'll do the same with the Juventus logo. I think I should have it. If I don't, I can always grab one. Yep, there it is. So this one's kind of weird. It almost has like a cartoony look with that line. Oh, you know what? Actually, I just remembered. We're going to go with the J logo. So we're going to actually want a new Juventus logo. Because this season they are officially switching to that horrendous looking, I mean, really, what have they done with a classic crest? Just made it look absolutely terrible. But anyways, they did officially switch to the new crest, so we are going to have to abide by those rules, as stupid as they are. And since this one, just what I'm seeing, there really is no way to make it like kind of an inverted crest as Milan have it. We're just going to have to do a blend mode screen because it is just one block of letters. Really, gosh, I can't get over what they did to that logo. It looks absolutely awful in my opinion. I get it that they were trying to rebrand or whatever, but man, they swung and missed with this one. I'm not really sure if I should keep the lettering at the top. I'll do it just for now, just so people know or people are reminded of the horrid, horrid actions of Juventus. But either way, there we go. Now the only thing left is the Twitter announcement, so I'll just show you quickly how to do that. I appreciate you guys bearing with me as I am going pretty quick, but I know a lot of you guys have requested this. So we always want to go to AC Milan Twitter. Now a lot of foreign clubs, the big ones, they have English Twitter accounts. So I know AC Milan, they tweet in both English and Italian sometimes. So what I like to do is I like to find the very first tweet, the one that absolutely 100% announces it. Let's see. So we're at 7 hours ago, 20 hours ago. I like that new pre-match shirt. Okay. We're definitely getting there. I'm not sure if we already passed the first one. I think we definitely did because it was announced yesterday. If it's a video, I don't really do it, or, I feel like typically there would be more, or there would be a bigger one. Let's see. Man, they have been very active in the transfer market. I think this one's the first one, actually. But what I am going to do is find, like, hopefully we have a picture of him holding up a Juventus shirt or something like that. Here we go. This one's kind of a perfect headline. AC Milan reached an agreement with Juventus for the transfer of Leonardo Bonucci subject to medical completion. So what I'm going to do, I'm on a Mac, so I'm going to press Shift-Command-4. And I'm just going to want to cut this directly. I can get the follow button in there, why not? And bam, now it's taking the picture. I don't need to include the picture down there, obviously. So now it saves them all directly to my desktop for some reason, all the screenshots. So I can just drag that in there, and I like to put it at the bottom, kind of in this open space, just to show it. I think that kind of wraps up, you know, the whole transfer. Like, there's the rumors, there's the leaked photos, there's everything. But when the club comes out and says it, it's official. So that's pretty much it, guys. That is how I do the transfer trackers. Like I said, if you just save the PSD and use it as your template, it really doesn't matter too much, as long as you are happy with it and as long as, you know, it's easy enough for you. Not really sure where I was going with that sentence, but guys, I am back. I hope to be doing videos regularly this summer. But I did hope you guys did enjoy this one. And always let me know requests and what directions I should take the channel in the comments below. I know I didn't make a video for it, but we are 2 years on YouTube. Just past 2 years, of June 19th was the first day. So I thank you guys for 2 years. I thank you guys for 3,000. And if you have made it this far, because I didn't announce at the beginning of the video, there's a special PSD for you guys in the description. So if you happen to read the description and you happen to make this that far, let me know. Hope you guys did enjoy this video. If this video helped you in any way, shape, form, please remember to give it a like, subscribe. Hope you all have a great day, and I will see you guys next time. Peace.